Hello everyone. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make glass candy. Before we begin, I should warn you, this stuff will get very hot and very sticky pretty fast, since, you know, it's candy and candy tends to do that. So, if this is your first time making something like this, I would recommend making this preferably not by yourself or just with someone. But maybe who knows what they're doing. With that out of the way, let's get started. Alright, so here are the things we're gonna need. We are going to need sugar, water, light corn syrup, food dye, flavoring of choice, candy thermometer, and for afterwards, powdered sugar. The recipe and everything else will be in the description if you'd like to follow along, but I would... Oh. And also candy molds. Again, I would recommend watching the video first and then going through with it. Alright, so first things first. First, we combine 2 cups of sugar, 2/3 cup of light corn syrup, and 3/4 cup water in 1 saucepan. So, I will do that real fast. Alright. So as you can see in there, I've added my sugar in, two cups of sugar, and I've put in my candy thermometer. Next, I'm going to put in my light corn syrup, 2/3 cup light corn syrup. The important thing to do with corn syrup, since it's sticky and you want this to be as accurate as possible, is to take a spatula and kind of like scoop around out of it. To make sure you get pretty much everything in there. Alright, now that I've got that in, I put in my water as well. Let's say 3/4 cup of water. Just pour that in there. Next, what you're going to do, You're going to turn it on the stove to medium to high heat. And you're going to kind of want to mix it around just a little bit so that way it at least slightly combines. You don't want to mix it too much though, as that comes later. All right. So now it has been at least slightly mixed, and I've got my thermometer in. I want to get it to, let's see, where is it? 260 degrees, I believe. 260 degrees. Just for a start. Oh, and one more thing. After your first initial mix, it is very important to not mix it again until I kind of say so, or when it's time to put in the food the food flavoring. Yes. Do not mix it again until you put in the food flavoring, or when I, let you know. Alright, so at some point your bubbles are going to start becoming less quick and more slow, kind of forming together, molten type. Mine's at, close to 200, I'd say, about. It's hard to see on this. Yep, close there. So again, we need to get it to 260. Do not stir, and make sure you are on constant watch for your candy temperature. You don't want to miss anything or let anything burn. Alright, so my candy is at 260 degrees now. So now what I do, I put in a few drops of my chosen food coloring. In this case, since I'm doing cinnamon, my chosen color is red. Now again, it is very, 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 very important that you do not stir it, since the bubbling action will mix the dye in. Also very important to note, at this point, reaching 300 degrees will not be very hard for the candy to reach. So it is very important that you make sure you are watching this one at all times, and to also get out a heat pad so you can put it on. Alright, so now my candy has reached 300 degrees. So now, take it off the heat and move it over to a heating pad. Also, make sure you turn off your stove. Look at that. It's all bubbly and hot. So, before you add in your flavoring, which in my case, cinnamon, I like to make sure the bubbles die down just a little bit. So that way, when I mix it, the flavor won't completely dissipate. Let's see what's... Also, don't forget to take this out. Make sure to shake as much off as you can, and I am going to very quickly... Cool. There we go. So, at this point, you just kind of wait for the bubbles to die down just a little bit. And next, what you do next, you are going to put in your food, your flavoring. Now, what is very important with this kind is that you do not want to mix directly above it, especially if it's cinnamon. Or peppermint. Yeah, if you do either of that, prepare to not be able to breathe for some time. Because trust me, it will burn. And it also creates, like, a ton of steam. So I'm going to mix it in. Make sure it's all poured in as much as you can get it. And then very gently start to mix everything around. As you can see, it really, really starts to steam up and stuff. Ugh. Oh god, my nose. Ow. Yeah, make sure that the bubbles have pretty much also kind of died down. You probably can't see this, but not enough that there's no bubbles, but kind of just enough so that way, you know, there are bubbles and there is evidence that it is still at least...